For lack of another name, I call this the Wellington Bromeliad number 2, because the original Wellington Bromeliad number 1 is over here, sitting at the base of this marquee palm. And the other one that I had a long time ago, I put over here. And a few rocks that when we first moved into the place, I purchased with the help of one of the so-called illegals that were working for Lennar. I don't know if they were illegal or not, but when I said, give me $20 for those two big stones over there, he had no problem putting them on the bulldozer for me and carrying them almost half a mile to the back of the house. And they tell people how much they cost me. It's crazy, but that's the number. And I just had a nice size hole in it, and I just set the Bromeliad in it, and every year it blooms like clockwork. And here's another, as you can see, all the little, I forget what they call it, but they're like little seeds that basically fly off. And as you can see, they sort of take a home just in the vicinity of the tree and fly around. And you got the bird over, but it's just impressive. And I have yet to get one that comes out of these trees. But that I call the Wellington Bromeliad number 1. Because I don't have the science to make along. And this one over here is the Wellington Bromeliad 2, an abbreviated portion, but has a rather unusual clustering habit and striking colors like the original one, as you can see. Let me pull down this other one. But they do get some beautiful colors, bright red, bright purple, dark purple, and it's worth having them on the property because one of those, just let me know. Money is no object for me, but maybe for you. But if you want me, I can just ship it in the priority box deal. Just let me know. Just if you want insurance, just pay for it. My goal is just to keep green for the rest of the world. Alright, thanks very much.